Hello and welcome. It's round four of the TikTok Women's Six Nations, and Scotland have travelled to Italy to try and secure their first win of the campaign. Joining me for this one are two former Scotland stars. We've got Megan Kennedy and Colin Gregor here with us this evening. Colin, how do we sum up Scotland's campaign so far? It's been ups and downs.
Yeah, just a bit frustrating. There's been so many positives. Some of the attacking play against England, some of the tries they scored down in Wales, just not quite getting over the line. And then the second half against France, that was they outscored France, which is a real positive coming into this game. So now it's about actually getting a win.
Yeah, absolutely. Italy are, of course, at the bottom of the table. They haven't scored any points yet. So I guess Scotland are going into this thinking, this is the team we can beat.
I think absolutely they need to go into the game with that attitude, but both teams are definitely going to be hungry for the win. Neither of them have won any matches so far. And Italy, strangely, have only scored one try, which is uncharacteristic. So I definitely think it's going to be a good game today.
There's a number of changes in this team today, a number of personnel changes and positional changes. One big loss is that Jade Conkle's not in the side. How big a blow is that?
Definitely, you can't argue that's definitely a big loss. She carries so well. I think she's like top metres made by a mile. So she's definitely a loss, but on the flip side, it gives players a chance. Against France, I thought Evie Gallagher carried tremendously well, so it'll be exciting to see her have a run at eight today.
Yeah, it will be indeed. Well, it's almost time for the action to get underway, so let me hand you over to our commentary team today, who are Thomas Duncan and Heather Lockhart.
Strap yourselves in for what could be one of the most closely fought and competitive games of this TikTok Women's Six Nations, with Italy and Scotland searching for their first win. Italy head coach Andrea Di Giandomenico makes six changes from the defeat by Ireland. In the forwards, Melissa Bettoni shifts to loose head prop, and in comes Vittoria Vecchini in her place at hooker. Ilaria Arrighetti makes her first start of the championship at number eight. In the back, Sofia Stefan starts at scrum half instead of Italy's most capped player, Sara Baratin. Captain Manuela Furlan switches to fullback, and Aura Muzzo fills the gap on the wing. Michaela Solari replaces Elisa Dinka at 13. Scotland have unfortunately lost the tournament's biggest carrier, Jade Conkle, for the rest of the tournament due to injury, so Evie Gallagher moves to number eight and Rachel McLachlan starts at open side flanker. The return of the vastly experienced Emma Wassell to the second row does soften the blow in Conkle's absence. The back line's been completely reshuffled as Katie Mattinson and Sarah Law form a new halfback partnership, which means Helen Nelson and Lisa Thompson both move out one position. Shona Campbell returns on the wing after some promising early performances. Among the replacements, Sara Baratin, all of her 104 cap experience there for Italy. Hannah Smith back and could make a late influence late on. The referee is Lauren Jenner of New Zealand, who's taking charge of her first ever Six Nations match. A big evening for her as well as it is for both of these teams. Former Scotland forward Heather Lockhart is alongside me. Heather, this could be a close one, couldn't it?
Yeah, really exciting match tonight. 17 degrees in Parma, both sides looking to unlock their attacking potential. So Scotland have never won a Six Nations match in Italy. They'll be looking to pick up their first win there, and Italy, I'm sure, will be looking to counter them on that.
Yeah, plenty of positives so far from Scotland, but the crucial W, the win, has evaded them so far. Italy here to come, and then Ireland, as Lisa Thompson gets things underway in Parma. And it's immediately into touch. Arrighetti kind of flopping over the line there, and Scotland will have an early line-out in a promising position, Heather.
Yeah, fantastic position on the 22. The back ball has been working, so it'll be interesting to see what the line-out call is here.
Yeah. Lana Skeldon will line up the throw. A few loose ones last week, but usually be a reliable. The first one is claimed by Wassell. Such a boost to have her back after missing out against France through injury. Here's Nelson in that new position of inside centre. Mattinson to Sarah Law. on her 50th cap. Last time out. Thompson into Evie Gallagher, replacing Jade Conkle at number 8.
Inside the 50.
Italy with a first chance with ball in hand to take it up.
Hold.
Looking for a clean exit.
Hold wide.
Kick long by Veronica Madia. No one back deep enough at home for Scotland, but they get back. Here's Nelson. Gives it to Lloyd. Mattinson in the scrum half. Our first Scotland start. Right.
Hold here.
Slow ball.
Your winner's on.
Box kick goes up. Lloyd's after it. It's taken by Stefan. Now it's run by Furlan. Oh, great touch from Furlan. She's away up the touchline. Her foot has stepped into touch. The Italian captain back at fullback this evening, and she's a threat, as evidenced there.
Absolutely. Scotland know all too well Furlan's threat. She scored a hat-trick against Scotland last year. And look at that powerful running there. Just foot just in touch. Good series of play there by both sides, just testing each other out.
Yeah, KG, a few kicks.
Time's on.
Bit of slow ball from both teams. First real sign of intent, but it's Scotland's ball. Lana Skeldon to throw. Italy up to disrupt and contest, but Scotland managed it. Hold on to it. Here's Gallagher, so effective in getting over the gain line.
Because it can play on from there. Okay, cool. Yeah.
And it looks like it's going to be
seven wide, taken in the air.
Yeah, taking in the air at the line out from Italy, and Scotland will have the penalty.
Yeah. Interesting. So there's Evie Gallagher on the screen there, starting at number 8 for the first time, and I'm sure should be looking to make her mark on this game in her own way. She's really been some outstanding performances from the flank for Scotland. So interesting to see tonight. I'm sure she'll be excited to make the number 8 how she does this evening.
She certainly made an impact in this tournament so far in the absence of Jade Conkle, who has carried more than anyone after the first three rounds of this tournament. They need to make up for that. Skeldon again. Lassell takes. Mattinson gets it away to Law. It's McLachlan in midfield to try and make some yards. Here's Law. Lisa Thompson.
Tackle!
Always
up. Tackle!
Willing carrier in that midfield.
Oh,
yeah. Right.
Well taken, Molly Wright. Well taken.
Difficult one for her, but she claimed and made the crucial meters, and that's a dangerous pass. And Italy were in there to intercept, and it's going to come back for a knock on.
Yeah, Scotland just looking to get some fluidity into the passages of play there. Just yeah, knock on by Italy there.
Last one.
Ilaria Arrighetti read it well, hands up, but wasn't really in a position to gather the ball. She missed the first two matches, Ilaria Arrighetti, the Stade Rennais back rower.
I'll move out of your way. I'll just send
you. Yeah, first Six Nations match for her. First scrum.
Crouch!
This will be interesting. Italy's scrum hasn't functioned too well so far. Scotland has been pretty solid, but here we go, first contest.
Oh, yeah.
Mattinson gets it away cleanly, solid from Scotland. Slow again, though, for the Scotland scrum half. Captain Malcolm. This goes back to Law, who hoists the kick into the air. Tests the Italian back three. Furlan takes. Italy is trying to run it. They do like to run the ball from deep. They like to play rugby, not a kicking team.
They definitely have kicking strength. So Beatrice Rigoni at number 12, very happy to take on the ball. And if she's on her game tonight, she's a real attacking threat, both with ball in hand and passing and kicking.
Italy using the forwards, but here's Stéphane, the scrum half, sniping round the edges. Doesn't get very far. Arrighetti is over it. That's a penalty to Italy. Molly Wright not rolling away.
Especially in the early stages, just squeaky clean. Lauren Jenner will just be looking to pick up anything like that. So, penalty Italy.
Hands off.
Yeah, it's one of the infringements that referees are very hot on, very fast, very consistent to call. You've got to get out of there once you've made the tackle, and Molly Wright done on that occasion, and Italy will have the chance to perhaps kick themselves up into Scotland's 22.
Perhaps. Tough one for Molly to get out of there, but referees called it.
There's always an element of the dark arts, players holding each other in, etc. But
indeed. Just going back to Jade not playing tonight, she's got a rib injury, and Jade has got 48 carries for 237 metres, so that's a real impact she's made in the last three matches, and we wish her well in her recovery. And if you're listening, Jade, good luck.
Yeah, it's such a difficult loss for Scotland, but they've defended well so far for not had the ball down their own half too often, but this is a chance for Italy. As scrum half Sofia Stéphane gets a bit of treatment on her
Your scrum's
knee.
Called, but time's still off.
They of course have Sarah Paratin, the most capped player, 104 caps on the bench. She's a more than able deputy to come on if needed.
Absolutely, first cap in 2005, absolute experience, and she actually scored against Scotland midway through the first half, the last time they played at the World Cup European qualifiers here in Parma. Scotland made definitely a better start the last time they gave away a try within 3 minutes, so a more settled start for both sides.
It'll be in theirs.
Not been too much.
Time's on.
Red zone action so far in the opening nearly 7 minutes. Italy with the scrum.
Crouch.
Molly Wright with a chance to make an impact here.
Sit.
Stéphane to feed.
Advantage
for Scotland going down on the far side, and Italy come away with it. They play advantage. It's Ragone into the hands of.
There's no advantage.
Knock on, but no advantage. Big penalty from the scrum.
Yeah, I think it'll be just losing the bind and pulling the scrum down on the far side and the loose head side for Scotland. Loose head means left hand side, tight head means right hand side for those that don't know.
Oh, far side number one. Far side. Flips.
Listen to the referee, Lauren Jenner, there, making it crystal clear.
Come again. Scrum school, girls. Scrum school.
It looks like Sofia Stéphane is unable to continue here. She's limping off. She did get some lengthy treatment on that knee, but.
Yeah, cool. So we got this way.
She's limped off, and it will be. Sarah Baratin, as we were mentioning, a vastly experienced scrum half. So, although it's disappointing for them to have to change so early, they've got a quality operator coming on.
Very much so, Italy, that if anything, it's like for like, and definitely a vast array of experience coming onto the pitch there.
Crouch!
Italy up for the scrum again.
It's interesting, they gave away four penalties against Ireland last week. Interesting.
Sit.
Yeah, you would think they would opt for the territory, but here they are. They're backing themselves, and they've held on well. Here they go. It's Madia, makes a gap. She makes a little break, and it's a good tap tackle there from McLaughlin. Just got round the ankles. Here come Italy. It's lost forward in possession there, and
forward pass.
Forward pass. The referee says, and Scotland will have the scrum.
Fantastic tap tackle there by Rachel McLachlan. Almost try saving there, I think. Great bait by Medea, number 10.
Yeah, that's good reading of the play. Just saw the gap, went for it, but McLachlan was alert, and it's a great tackle. Okay, and that's the forward pass, I think, there. Well, if Scotland are to pick up their first win today, they're going to have to come against a run of form against Italy. It's not the best they've won. Just one of the last 10 Six Nations matches against Italy. Only won six of their 22 meetings overall. But it is a team who, despite results, have been playing some good stuff, and here they come away with it. Mattinson looking for a quicker ball.
No.
It's not too forthcoming, it's back to Law.
Hold blue, hold blue, hold blue, everyone.
Verlaine takes. Sends the chip over, but Emma Wassel was alert to it, charged it down.
There's no advantage. Just here.
But we're back for a Scotland
penalty. Offside.
Offside, says the referee.
Oh, so they're offside, sorry. Okay, cool. Hi, guys. Well, sorry, guys. I'm reversing it. You guys were offside. You were offside. The penalty is to Scotland. Back 10. The penalty is to Scotland. You guys were offside. Offside.
You can hear Lauren Jenner explaining there.
All good.
Italy
yeah.
encroaching up too quickly, looking to get that blitz defence into action, but too keen. And Lisa Thompson clutches the ball and can try and get Scotland some field position.
That's an outstanding kick. Outstanding.
Huge from Lisa Thompson. And she's been doing that pretty regularly in the three games so far. Excellent right foot.
She really does a power of work around the field, Lisa Thompson. 29 and carries as well as her kicking. Verlaine as well on 29 carries for the total three matches. Been.
And playing at outside centre today, been playing at inside centre in the previous games, and that's not straight from Anna Skeldon. Frustrating.
Scrum.
An opportunity
scrum.
Passes Scotland by.
Yeah, that was unlucky there. Both teams just know they need to get their processes right.
It's a disappointing one because Italy didn't really contest that, so frustration for Scotland, but they can try and put Italy under pressure here and make sure they don't get an easy exit from their 22.
Yeah, the scrums have been fairly even, so we'll see what happens in this one.
Crouch! Sit. Nah, yep. She's down. She's gone down.
It's a free
down.
Kick to Scotland here. Early hit.
No. Back here. Yeah, where you are.
Rachel Malcolm a bit too keen. Doesn't take it on the mark, but this is a fantastic opportunity.
Yeah,
after
ready.
That squint line out, they've got the ball back, and here goes McLachlan.
Good option, keeping ball in hand.
Yeah.
Oh. Mattinson whips it to Malcolm. It's a little nudge from Bonner. Here's Sarah Law, outside to Nelson. Thompson, on to Shona Campbell. Jinx inside.
Lost now, 13, lost.
Kayla Solari was in there trying to disrupt for Italy, and then she's lying there, and it's quick from Mattinson. She tries to go quickly for the line, but the referee's having none of it.
Quick tap, it has to be on the mark. You've got two options. You've got one here for off-feed, or you've got one in the middle of the field for offside. Captain? You've got one here for off-feet and one in the middle for offside. In the middle. All right.
They've gone middle of the pitch. You heard the referee there saying Italy offside again. And also you saw Michaela Solari trying to get in and pinch the ball on the far side that was unable to.
Points.
Went off her feet. And this is another good, promising field position. And what will the decision be for Scotland? It looks like they're going to take the points on offer.
Yeah, good decision. Get the scoreboard ticking.
Awesome.
That's
you.
Good pressure there by Scotland and good option to take the free kick and keep ball in hand.
Helen Nelson with her first attempt at goal. It's as easy a starter as you would like for Helen Nelson, and she makes absolutely no mistake. And Scotland are on the board, 3-0 up after 14 minutes, a positive start.
Yeah, fantastic start there, 14 minutes in. And I think Scotland just need to keep that pressure and I think keep more ball in hand. Italy are dangerous on the counter-attack, as Manuela Ferlan showed there, and Medea. So keep more ball in hand and keep the territory and keep taking advantage of any penalties.
It looks like Manuela Ferlan, the Italian captain, has also had to limp off with an injury at fullback, which is a really big blow. So Minuzzi is on in her place. Two injuries already among the Italian ranks, and that restart
no,
is
not
gone 10, so we'll go back for a scrum on halfway.
Yeah, it's interesting that, because this year's Six Nations, there's three matches in a row, and then an off week, and then two matches. So the three matches in a row, maybe just some injuries creeping in there, and even with the off week, maybe thinking that they would be okay, but not to be.
Vittoria Minuzzi started against England and Ireland, so it's not like she's coming in cold completely, but still, Manuela Ferlan, as we saw with that brief break up the left, is such a threat, and she's the Italian captain, 84 caps. So it's disappointing for Andrea Di Giandomenico, the Italian head coach, so early to lose two players in key positions.
Yeah, especially the captain.
Martinson gets it away to Law.
Puts the
kick up. It bounces just in, and Rona Lloyd's there, as is Campbell, or as Chloe Rowley, in fact. Try scorer last week.
Superb kick there by Sarah Law.
And Italy now pinned back. Scotland looking to put the pressure on. Good carry though by Jordana Duca. Goes back to Madia with a left foot, who makes decent touch.
That left foot's very useful on an exit on that side. Nice kick there from her.
You just sense, Heather, that neither team's been able to get any fluidity in their play so far. Maybe a bit nervy or a bit rusty, having not played for a couple of weeks.
Yeah, just trying to play the percentages and just suss out the game. But I think Scotland have learned that they need to start well and then keep the pressure on. So they'll be looking to keep the scoreboard ticking and build on their 3 points.
Skeldon, the last one was Squint. Gets it to Bonner this time. And Scotland set up the maul. Skeldon with it at the back. Pops it to Martinson. Nelson carries.
Ball's out.
Ball was out, the referee called, and
ball's out.
Scotland scrum half under pressure, and the turnover is forced. Here's Beatrice Ragone, and a spiral kick finds Campbell.
Tackle!
Italy looked at ragdoll the Scotland wing into touch, but the visitors still have it. Here's Skeldon, good line. The captain, Malcolm. And penalty, Italy. This time, Michaela Solari did get in there, did get on the ball, and Rachel Malcolm pinged for holding on.
Yeah, the opening few minutes, Scotland were looking after the attacking rucks. They just got to be careful there and not give penalties away at the breakdown. Here you see there are three penalties each, Italy and Scotland, so you want to keep that penalty count down.
Girls, I'm on the line, so we just hit medium at this way.
Numbers, please. Good position for Italy. They've already run off a couple of set pieces so far, so probably see light wides, but it doesn't go to hand. It's just about claimed by Lucia Guy. Here's Ragone. Baratin gets it away. Duca, Baratin to Madia, Ragone.
Yeah, hold here.
Baratin to Madia, into midfield again. Huge double hit from Scotland. Molly Wright and Rachel McLaughlin in there. Italy still with possession. And there's a hand in there, and that's illegal. And Italy get another penalty, and this one's probably kickable if they fancy it.
Yeah, Scotland there with just with two penalties, just giving away territory that they don't want to do that. And as you say, let's see what they're going to do with this one.
Looks like Rigoni's going to kick to touch. There's a good position. Italy, of course, joining Scotland at the World Cup, and it Six. Looks like Manuela Furlan is preparing to come back on. So I don't know if it was a head injury assessment or a blood bin, but she's now agitating to come back on the pitch.
Yeah, ready to go. Melissa Batone still throwing the ball in, although at scrum she's playing it at loose head prop, but still throwing the ball in.
Yeah, interesting. Usually the hooker's job. Oh, of course, she plays hooker.
Exactly. First time at loose head today.
Here go Italy, looking to get some power in that maul. It drives on. It's Veronese with a ball at the back of it. It goes down. They're only 5 metres out. It's Baratin, Madia. Here's Rigoni, little pop, but a huge hit from Lisa Thompson. Crunching tackle. Here's Madia. Spins it wide to Minuzzi. Another good tackle. Round the legs. Rona Lloyd that time. Baratin. Italy still going. Law makes the tackle. Duca. Trucking it up for Italy. Scotland trying to get in and disrupt. They slow the ball down effectively. Baratin. Another big hit coming in as Lucia Guy tries to smash her way through. It's right to Madia. Italy looking for numbers. It's Rigoni. Jinks back inside.
Roll.
Scotland making their tackles. Advantage as a referee.
You can't play on. We can play on from there. Captain.
There's going to be a word.
Rolling. Or entry over here. Just once again. Do you want it here or over there?
Well, Lauren Jenner just explaining there's a choice of two penalties again, so Italy have their pick of where they want it from.
Okay, cool,
which, if you're kicking to touch, probably doesn't make any difference, but if they want to take the points, then you maybe take this more central one, obviously.
Yeah? Okay, cool. We'll go here.
Some really good hard carries there by Italy. Baratin really conducting things at the base of the ruck there, and Madia has her pass is really excellent, and Rigoni pops back inside or goes herself. She actually cut back inside there on a good line. So the variety of play from the 9, 10 and the 12 is keeping Scotland on their toes, but good defence here by Scotland. But again, watching the penalty count.
Another lengthy stoppage with another Italian body needing some treatment, but it's obviously disrupts the flow of the game. It has been a bit bitty so far. Not too much fluidity from either side.
Yeah, the last time they played was at this ground, and Magatti and Baratin scored in the 23rd and the 24th minute. So they had, this is where Scotland need to really focus on their defence and relieve pressure and simple exits.
You can see their possession, 55-45 in Scotland's favour. Only England have had more possession.
I'm trying to wait as much as possible for you to get it before we go to the next one. So.
In this tournament so far, yeah, but it's what you do with it. And Scotland haven't quite, by their own admission, done enough when they have had all that ball. And it's been a bit the same tonight so far in the first quarter.
Yeah, when Scotland played England were in Scotland's 22 for 44 seconds, whereas Scotland were in England's 22 for 5 minutes 25. So it's been clinical, and Brian Easton talked about that ahead of this game, about being composed and being clinical. So that's very much their game plan for tonight.
Yeah, both Italy and Scotland propping up the table. Italy at the bottom, Scotland fifth when it comes to points per entry into the opposition's 22, and obviously a large part of why they are both winless at the moment. But
definitely both sides.
Cool. Time's on, girls.
Playing somewhat more attacking intent this evening.
And it is going to be points attempted for Italy. It's going to be Michaela Cillari. Experienced kicker, accurate kicker. You would expect her to get this one. And she does. All square. And Italy doing what Scotland did just a few moments ago and getting up that end tether and, you know, taking something from it.
Yeah, absolutely. I think both sides looking just to get the scoreboard ticking and to get something from the 22, and they'll be happy to take those 3 points. Cillari there with a distinctive scrum cap.
It'll be Thompson to restart for Scotland again, and they'll look to quickly get back up the other end. Not really strung the phases together they would like so far. It's taken by Arachetti again, just about, almost spilled it. Baratin holds. Relies on her forwards to make the yards to perhaps set up the exit, but they go again. Another penalty. Ollie Wright again not getting out the way there.
Yeah, Lauren Jenner being quite clear in her communication to both teams. Must roll away once tackled.
Rigoni gets Italy up to just before halfway. This is the penalty here. You can see Molly Wright looks to go in on the ball.
Okay.
Yes, it was actually Evie Gallagher there that was not as quick as the referee would have liked.
It looks like Manuela Furlan, by the sounds of it, is going to come back on, and it was an HIA, a head injury assessment. She'd obviously got a knock, and she's done the test that she needed to do with the doctor and passed, so she comes back on, the Italian captain for Ostuni Manuzzi. Another not straight.
Outside shoulder, not straight, not straight. Strong goes. Strong.
Yeah, both Scotland and Italy have been pulled up by the referee for not straight, maybe just a few nerves, etc., when the hookers get their range. Not much wind in the stadium this evening, so just be getting their range.
No excuse.
Big match, so it takes a lot for the hookers to stand there and get composed.
Indeed, and here is a chance for Scotland. With some decent territory, they've scrummaged solidly so far. There's Mathenson to flip it away. Nelson, first receiver, into Thompson, gets over the gain line. Law, Campbell, lovely hands. It's Chloe Rowley, in fact, just the little puff across.
Italian defence are coming up really sharp on that outside channel.
Wally Wright evades the tackler.
Advantage
Scotland. Thompson smashes off Rigoni.
Lost wide, leave it.
Nelson into McLachlan. Here's Malcolm. Law for Wright. Scotland not making many meters at the moment. They had the advantage, and Law does now opt to kick the little dink in behind. It's picked up by Furlan.
Yeah, the Italians have done their homework. They know the threats are out wide for Scotland, and they're really nullifying them and taking their chances here.
Here's a break from Muzzo. Baratin gets it to Magatti. Using the short side. Right, round the ankles, does the job. Here's Madia, again steps back inside, looks for the blind pop, hits the referee.
On the way. Italy ball.
Yeah. That was a nice little pop, and I don't think the referee was expecting that little pop back inside. I think Italy have definitely done their homework. They know Scotland's threat, they're coming up sharp on the outside there. There's Chloe Rowley. And then nice break there on the counter attack. And also as well, Scotland, when they played England, there were some holes around the middle, and I think Italy were just testing them there just to make sure there's any space there around the inside channels.
Crouch.
Scotland ahead in the tackle count. Not had much of the ball recently. Forced to defend. Baratin. Just puts the ball in, good shove from Scotland. Italy going backwards, and it's a penalty.
That's it. Molly's absolutely every right to celebrate that one. Well done. Molly playing her first start today at Loosehead Prop. First start ever. She normally plays hooker for Scotland. And well done. Her and Lana Skeldon have played together. Molly at Loosehead and Lana at hooker for club at Watsonians, both their former clubs. So they have some experience there. So that.
You can see Rachel Malcolm, the captain, with a fist, clenched fist, because...
She always says she's the scrum's biggest cheerleader, which is fantastic.
Well, she... Obviously, if you can get the upper hand in the scrum and, as they say, paint a picture for the referee, it can prove invaluable in field position, and this is another chance for Scotland to throw in. Wassell claims it off the top. Gallagher carrying strongly. McLachlan. Here's Gallagher again, putting in a shift already. Here's Thompson. Thought about passing, went inside. Here's Law. Finds Wright, who just puts the head down, makes the yards.
Lost now, leave it!
Law, Nelson, well marshalled by Solari.
Scotland are finding it hard to get round Solari on the outside there.
The ball's slow again, and it's back for Lisa Thompson, who always seems to bust the first tackle. And they have advantage, none forthcoming, and it's a penalty to Scotland.
Well worked, Lisa Thompson. That started for some fantastic carries over on the other side. Evie Gallagher carried a couple of times, and Rachel McLachlan really trying to make some good yards for Scotland. Well done. Italy's defence on that outside, Solari, really causing problems for Scotland, and at the breakdown as well there.
Yeah, Solari missed last week after a bit of a COVID outbreak in the, or 2 weeks ago, I should say, in the Italy camp, but back in at 13. She's vastly experienced. It's her 66th cap. Thompson doing well, playing opposite her this evening. Okay. Another chance for Scotland to get some front football.
Hands off, girls.
Got another Italian casualty here. They've obviously...
It still looks warm enough, so I think both sides will be happy just to get some water on the half-hour mark. Oh, it's a contact for Lucia
contact
Guy.
Contact lens up.
80th cap for Lucia Guy tonight. A real rock for Italy in the scrum at tight head.
Speaking from experience, not always comfortable putting the contact lens in.
I'll take your word for it. So crucial time with 10 minutes to go before half time. Scotland in a good position here.
Wassell, Bonner, both been options in the lineup for Scotland. Who will they go for this time? It's Wassell at the front. And the mall gets going.
Out one! Out now!
Here they go, Scotland, Italy all at sea. The yards being eaten up. They inch towards the 5 metre line. They're still going. Lana Skeldon still has it, pops her head out, makes a little dart for the line. Held up. Mattinson to Nelson. Show and go, but she's isolated. Helen Nelson and Italy get in over the ball. Scotland just about safe possession, and it's advantage now. McLachlan. Here's Wassell. Her run of 54 straight appearances coming to an end last week, but back in the team. Here's Nelson. Chloe Rowley, well met by Beatrice, Solari again. As you were mentioning, Heather, just so quick off the mark.
Yeah, very much so. They've done their homework. They know they have to shut that channel down. And
offside, Chloe Rowley, two tries for Scotland in this tournament so far, and they're giving her absolutely zero room as another bit of treatment goes in.
That was a really, really good maul. Excellent, a good line-out call, simple one to the front. Emma Wassell's only taken four all tournaments so far, but a good option here and good control.
No problem.
Lana breaking off. And again, Emma Wassell making that run there.
You see, they know what a threat Chloe Rowley poses. And
they're going to give her absolutely no space at all.
So Scotland will likely nudge this into the corner. Lisa Thompson does just that.
The maul really has become a bit of a weapon for Scotland. It's probably not been come out so much in these last three matches, so they'll be looking to make their mark with it tonight.
Skeldon, who will hope to make this, she does, and then become the beneficiary if it rumbles over, but they go quick, they try a little move as Belial tried to pop it to Skeldon, but an Italian arm was in there.
Offwides, options. Okay, sorry guys, we've lost our props. So you've got the options, it was lost forward into touch, line out, we'll scrum.
I can see what the idea was there and coming and veering it, but I think the driving maul had worked, and maybe just do it again because Italy weren't coping with it the first time.
Girls, we spoke about this. This is your last warning for that. I'll free kick you next time.
Lauren Jenner clear there. Not happy with something about the Scotland setup, and this time it goes to Belial again. And she's so close now. Scotland looking to get over. It's Wassell. Mattinson's there. Gives it to Gallagher, who goes sideways, then forward.
Tackle!
Held up. Lost gets the ball to Deck. Mattinson into Bonner. Gets the offload away to McLachlan, who does well to
tackle!
Keep hold of that ball.
That's it,
Italy hanging on at the moment. It goes wide. There's Nelson. Out to Rowley. It's into the corner for Shona Campbell. She's hit well. Malcolm. Scotland lost a few yards as they went wide, looking to regain them here, but they're up quick on Belial. It's Solari again, the outside centre. Her tackle count through the roof already. Thompson with a brilliant pass. Oh, it's just gone forward.
That was an excellent set of rugby there, both in attack and defence. Some outstanding carries and some outstanding defence. Lovely pass out there to Shona, but superb tackle there by Mutso.
Yaura Mutso not giving her any space out there.
Superb tackle on Christine Belial. Christine Belial had a brilliant carry off the line out. Italy have done their homework and know what a threat she was in France. So up super quick.
Rona Lloyd's two tries against Wales. Another one of Scotland's very potent back three threats.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, in the last 10 matches, the back
up,
three. And Lana Skeldon have all scored at some point in the last Scotland's last 10 matches, so Italy have done their homework.
Yeah, for you guys. Four blue bins, that's great. Cool.
Should qualify that, the back three, Megan Gaffney, who's on the bench tonight. I'm sure she'll be coming on at some point. The bench, super strong tonight for Scotland. Jenny Maxwell, Hannah Smith and Megan Gaffney all set to come on during the second half to raise the tempo again.
So we're seeing the referee calling there a high tackle, which hopefully we're about to see here. It is indeed.
Number
Rachel
one,
Malcolm taking
high tackle.
A bit of an arm in the face. It's a good spot from the officials.
Yeah.
And suddenly, from an Italy scrum, Scotland have another crack at a maul, you would suspect. A great time to score it would be as well, 5 minutes before the break. Basel claims it, high in the air. Here we go, Scotland making ground. Skeldon has it now. She's getting the tap from Mattinson, who gets it. There's Sean Campbell, short side.
Leave it, lots of wide.
Scotland 3 metres out, taken up again. Mattinson to Bonner. Lunges for the line, doesn't quite make it. Here's Wassell, Emma Wassell. They go back short side. It's just
tackles
round ankles for Italy. McLaughlin, Scotland getting ever closer. Italy holding firm at the moment, it's Malcolm. Forwards lining up to blast their way over. Mattinson has a look, goes the other way. It's Malcolm, popped inside to right. She breaks the first tackle, held up brilliantly though.
Wide, leave it.
Duca in there, making the difference for Italy. And it's over for Wassell, who grounds the ball, does she? She says it's good. She insists it's good. But it's the referee's decision that counts.
Ben, Tamo, coming to you.
They're going to check.
An unfair decision is held up because I haven't seen it across the ground, but I just want to make sure it hasn't crossed the line, gone to ground, and then been held up.
Okay, on-field decision is held up, but we're checking for a grounding first, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, 2 seconds and we'll get the best angles.
So you can hear the on-field decision is held up, no try, which means they need clear evidence that a try was scored.
We'll just get that angle. It's probably a best one, but she's just shown.
Ben Whitehouse, the TMO this evening.
Bear with us. Here it comes now.
Is that a double
movement?
Lauren,
I have a decision for you. You need to overturn your on-field decision.
It was
the first grounded short, and in one movement, she's grounded it over
she's
the line.
The
try here we go, it's going to be a try. Try Scotland. Emma Wassell insisted she was over. And on review, the officials agree. And a fantastic score for Scotland. And their patience is rewarded.
Yeah, some lady, Emma Wassell. Well done. 54 consecutive matches for Scotland. Missed the last match against France, but is now back. And what a way to make a statement. She said, there's so much we're determined to get right and have every ounce of belief that we will. She said that earlier this week. So, Emma, well done. You're true to your word.
Yeah, and she would have been absolutely gutted to miss the last game, but makes all the difference here. Helen Nelson looking to add the extras. Fantastic kick from Nelson, and 5 points become 7 for Scotland, and suddenly they have a 7-point lead as half-time approaches.
Yeah, this match definitely has a different complexion to the last couple of times Scotland have played Italy, and Scotland very much chasing that win in Italy in the Six Nations.
Spotted the gap there, Emma Wassell, intelligent. Scotland don't quite gather the restart, which isn't exactly how you would want to close out the first half, but line up to make the tackles.
No, she's fine. Ball still in.
Baratin to Madia. Beatrice Veronese with a carry for Italy. It's Madia. Here's Rigoni to Furlan. The tackle from Nelson. Nadia again. Good hands from Italy until the last, when it goes forward and.
Yeah, forward there. Forward.
A big boost for Scotland that.
Some really organised defence here by Scotland. Italy trying to make inroads on the attack, but Scotland just really organised.
It's a knock on here. See the law with the dump tackle. Puts her down safely though.
Yeah, always dangerous when you've just scored and then you have to be very much on your watch and totally just reset, and Scotland need to be ready to go again.
Ready?
Italy be looking to get on the scoreboard before half-time too, so it may only be a minute and a half on the clock, but that minute and a half, precious, really, really important time in a match.
Little break in play here.
All right, we're going, girls.
There's Emma Wassell. A try scorer for Scotland.
Yeah. She calls the line out, so I think she's making some good calls tonight. The shorter ones there, the pressure they had when they were down the other side, and that pressure eventually told. Great leg drive.
And I suppose in the absence of a senior player like Jade Conkle, to have her straight back in the team, Emma Wassell, is invaluable for Scotland, really, isn't it?
Yeah, I remember when she first came into the team, and she's just grown, and such commitment with all her other responsibilities.
Coach!
Well done, Emma.
Yeah, recently qualified as a chartered accountant amidst qualifying, helping to qualify Scotland for the World Cup.
Yeah,
not a bad year's work so far for Emma Wassell.
That's a lot of hard work and a lot of early mornings and late nights and getting organised. Well done, Emma.
Scrum reset here. Scotland look to just see out this first half. It's not been the most fluid from either team, but what Scotland have done is, unlike the previous games, been clinical.
Coach!
There's a lovely smile there by Katie Mattison. Well done, Katie.
She's on our first start for Scotland, looking to put the ball in safely here, get it back.
Stay half.
Which they do. It's Gallagher to take it out in the scrum half, prods it forward. Ferlan claims it, the Italy captain. Hoists it up in the air. Mattinson's underneath it, just about claims it, second attempt. Here's Rowley. Steps inside, goes to deck.
Thank you.
And we are now in the red. Scotland will look to just put this into touch, you would think.
Time's up.
They get the signal from the referee.
Scotland better in these last few minutes in the contact here as well, making that ball secure.
And there we go. Sarah Law will put it in touch, and there is the referee's half-time whistle. A positive first half from Scotland. Helen Nelson gave them the lead with a penalty. Michaela Solari responded for Italy, but it's Emma Wassell's try just a couple of minutes before the break, which means it's Italy 3, Scotland 10 at half-time.
Yes, at the break, it's Italy 3, Scotland 10. A bit of a start-stop opening 40 minutes. There wasn't a whole lot to separate the sides, but Scotland's Emma Wassell in the last few minutes leaping over the line, giving the visitors the lead going into the break, and some happy Scotland faces there as well. Yes, Colin, it maybe took a little while for them to get started, but Scotland are going to be happy going into the break after that first 40.
Yeah, absolutely. A really good try. When the times they've been in and around Italy's 22, they've come away with points. The penalty, first of all, and then the excellent try, which really buoys them, because Italy in the middle part of that first half, they were the dominant team. But I think Scotland's defence on the whole was really, really good. And whilst Italy did have moments of real attacking threat, actually on the whole, Scotland's defence was pretty comfortable, even on their own line. So yeah, there's loads for Scotland to be really buoyed by in that.
Yeah. Do you think that was quite their game plan, or do you think they were maybe a bit nervous out there? Because they were a bit slow to start a couple of unforced errors.
Yeah, I think they were just settling into the game, finding their feet, sort of assessing how Italy were going to be. It's been a very evenly fought match. I think both sides have shown great passages of play. And yeah, I think it's just great to go into the half-time in the lead.
Well, indeed, Scotland are in the lead. Let's talk through the try that just happened moments before the break there. Emma Wassell just leaping over the line, Megan.
Yeah, she had a fair bit of work to do. A really good step inside, and I think when she did get over the line, there was no doubt that she was confident she'd scored it. But I think it was just a reward of a lot of hard work. The forwards have put in a huge shift in the first half. They've carried well. But as you can see here, Emma just steps inside, and she still has a fair bit of work to do, but she's in no doubt that it was down.
Yeah, Emma was in no doubt it was down. There was a little bit of humming and hawing from the referee, okay, but Emma was sure. I mean, she obviously missed two weeks ago against France, so it's just fantastic to have her back in fit health.
Yeah, absolutely. I think she leads in more ways than I think she thinks she does. Even just her presence is so important, so it's great to have her back this week.
Yeah. I think the really smart attack from Scotland there was actually just keeping it in the forwards, because the attack before then, they'd gone a bit wider, and Italy's defence out wide had negated Scotland, and they were pushing Scotland back, and it was only actually because of the high tackle, the TMO that intervened, that Scotland got another chance. Mm. But the good thing, they learnt from that, so they didn't think, right, we'll try and attack to the width again. Let's just go with our forwards and assert dominance there, whether it's Emma Wassell carrying. I think all the back row had a couple of carries during that phase. It was just a real good team try, but the forwards in particular.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's talk a little bit about Italy's attack, Colin, because they were obviously really putting some pressure on Scotland early on in the first half, just not quite getting over that line at any point.
No, it's great recognition, good fielding of the box kick, and then I think it's the fullback Furlan who beats the Scotland defence. It's the touchline that comes to Scotland's saviour on that occasion, just can't quite stay in the field. And here it's just really crisp passing, just recognising where the space is. Scotland have to defend quite passively because of the attacking scrum. Unfortunate for Italy to knock it on. This occasion, great recognition, just stepping inside Matheson, the Scotland scrum half, just overchases, and Madia realises that and picks that inside line. And then just again, unfortunate that the forward pass is called there, so the good work is undone. Mm. On this attack, it's as much good Italian attack as good Scottish defence. Well, look at that hit from Lisa Thompson, just immediately shutting down the attack. But again, the zip in the pass, trying to get to the width for Italy. Rona Lloyd making a really effective tackle there. This time Italy just going a bit tighter, using the grunt of the forwards. But you've got to credit the Scotland defence, just low tackles, chopping the Italian to ground. Either one person going in to try and get look at slowing the ball down, or actually leave the breakdown, get numbers on their feet so that you can apply pressure with that line speed and make the dominant tackles that we saw there from Lisa Thompson and the like.
Did we expect Italy to come out like that? Because they did seem to really hold up Scotland quite a few times, and they were putting some, you know, pressure on Scotland very early on in the first 40 minutes.
Italy are playing at home. They've not won any games. There's big pressure on them. They may be a bit nervy. They like to throw the ball around. I think the good thing for Scotland, as we see here, when Scotland get into Italy's 22, they just apply pressure. They took a tap penalty from a free kick. It's excellent hands to get the ball out. I think it's Shona Campbell on that left wing making a little bit of yards, and you can see Italy just lying in the way there. It gets their outside centre. And Matheson, unfortunate, she couldn't take the quick tap penalty, but actually there'd been a previous infringement right under the posts. No mistake with the kick, and it gets Scotland, especially when you're playing away from home, get on the scoreboard, get some points, build some pressure.
Yeah.
We're going to talk in a second about Scotland's scrum. Colin Gregor, our scrum expert. We might not come to you because we were discussing earlier whilst the game was on.
Yep.
You've not spent too much time in a scrum. But it seems that Scotland were perhaps lacking fluidity. How do they change that for the second half?
I think do more of what they've done in the last maybe 20 minutes of the first half, 10 to 20 minutes of the first half. I think each week it's been a different team that's been out there, and they'll just be getting to find their feet a little bit, find out how people are going to play.
Let's look at this powerful scrum now. Well, we'll come to you, Megan, on this one, shall we? I mean, they've obviously put some practice into this.
Yeah, that just makes me happy seeing that. Yeah, just great. Obviously, this is Molly Wright's first scrum at Loosehead. Well, not first scrum, sorry, first game at Loosehead. And as much as that's a physical battle, I think it also has a lot of psychological impact as well. To get one up on an opposition scrum is big, so they'll take pleasure in that, I think.
We've talked a lot, Colin, about Scotland needing consistency. So they're obviously going to be happy leading going into the break. How do they keep that consistency for the second half?
It's almost just taking it in small chunks and not thinking actually about the 80-minute mark. It's just thinking about, right, start the half really well. So the first job that everyone has, let's be really accurate with that. Okay, then look at the next 5 minutes, next 10 minutes. I think where Italy have built a bit of pressure is probably from ill discipline from Scotland. They've got field position, or they've a couple of times they've launched attacks from scrums because Scotland have conceded penalties. So if Scotland can cut out them and back their defence, because they should take real confidence from the attack. Italy's attack has been good, but Scotland's defence has been even better, and it's just snuffed anything out. So yeah, back yourselves, and then when in positions or get field position, but in attack, just have a bit of composure, keep varying the attack. So sometimes go to the width, sometimes just go up the middle, as they have been doing. And then it's just about, just building and making it incredibly difficult for Italy to get anything.
Megan, what is Scotland head coach Brian Eason saying to the side right now in the changing room?
I think he'll be very pleased. There's obviously a lot of positives to take from that first half, but there are still elements that they could improve on. So I think it'll be a very different conversation from the halftime they had against France, but very much the same aim. They go out there and they nil them this half, and they come away with the win.
Well, round four of the TikTok Women's Six Nations is, of course, across this weekend spread. Tomorrow, England host Ireland. You can see that one live from midday on BBC Two. And last night, France won comfortably 33-5 against Wales in Cardiff. Let's have a look at the best bits from that match now.
Wales finding themselves in defensive mode for all of these opening exchanges. And there is Sansus again, just testing that defence, keeping them honest, and there's space now. Sansus cuts back inside, sidestep, she's over the line. Has she got that ball down? It's in the hands of Beth Ann Lewis. But the whistle has gone. The try has been awarded.
She really had to score that. There were plenty of numbers outside. If she hadn't scored this, she would have had some angry teammates around her.
And Tremoulier, all the time in the world, goes to Bujard, but it's a cruel bounce. Does it land in Bujard's hands? It does. We may have to have a look at this again.
I think Bujard was in front of the kicker. I think that's close.
Yeah, it looks good from that angle.
So this is the best angle here.
So Jazz Joyce gets a hand to it first. She seems to be robbed in midair.
I'm happy that she's control of the ball and the ball is grounded.
Guys, try stand.
So definitive from the TMO. Penalty Wales. French hands in that ruck, not releasing.
Yeah. Leave her.
And Kira Bevan looks to take this one quickly. Scampers upfield and chips the ball over the top into the hands of Chloé Jacquet. And France start a counter-attack of their own. Sansus, this is Jacquet, lovely step inside. There's clear space open up in front of her. Has she got the pace to get to the line? Yes, she has! What a counter-attack from France. Just when Wales look to be attacking themselves, France with a killer blow, and it shows just how clinical they can be.
What a killer step on the inside. She is an incredibly strong runner. Just got that bite in that step.
So the pressure remains on. It is a Welsh feed, but they are very close once again to their own try line. And somehow France have dispossessed Wales and snuck over for another try for Laure Sansus, the arch predator. Six tries now in this campaign to date.
That's a really frustrating one for Wales.
Advantage.
Advantage being played, Chambon. There was space on the blind side. She's gone open. Tremoulier looks to pass, sails over the line, effortlessly so. Jessie Tremoulier, the world player of the decade, makes things so easy here in Cardiff.
Advantage, yeah.
That one's gone immediately to ground. There's another advantage being played. And Wales thunder towards the try line. Can they finish with a flourish? A reach from Seanan Harris.
Incredible skills there from Seanan Harris. Not just power, but flexibility to twist herself around the body, know exactly where the try line is.
So Wales have the try they've been crying out for. If you look across the stand, the flags are being held aloft.
Yes, it was a fantastic win for France yesterday. Let's assume that England are going to beat Ireland tomorrow, you know, I don't want to put any words in anyone's mouth, but let's say that that's going to happen, then it's all going to come down to a final weekend showdown between between them two. That's going to be some match between France and England.
Yeah, and if it was in England, I think you'd comfortably say England are streets ahead, but the fact that it's in France, French rugby teams playing at home are totally different animals. And you see with the times that Sansus is on the field, France are a different animal. I think against Scotland, it was around half-time that she came off. Same against Wales, and France didn't really score many more points in her absence. So she's so, so important to that French team. But England are... I think they're a different level just now.
They are. They seem to be streaks ahead of everybody at the minute. But like you say, Sansus just controls the game. So I'm very intrigued to see how the England manage her around the pitch.
Are we closing that gap between England and France and the other nations? Are we getting any closer?
I do believe so. I think women's rugby's heading in the right direction and it's great to see. Italy just awarded 25 contracts to their players, which is phenomenal. So in terms of support, I think the gap is definitely closing. Performance-wise, the scores maybe don't show that at the minute, but if you look at the individual performances, there's definitely improvements.
Who's going to win the Women's Six Nations, Colin?
I think England are going to. I think they'll go over to France and they'll turn the French over. I think more importantly, from a Scottish point of view, that Scotland are going to win this game this evening. 10-3 up at half-time.
You're positive about it. Well, shall we hand back to our commentary team? Because we do want to see what happens in the next 40 minutes. Our commentary team tonight is Thomas Duncan, and Heather Lockhart.
Thank you, Laura. It's finally poised. Scotland 40 minutes away from a first Six Nations win. Tantalising, but Italy will, I'm sure, battle till the very end. They too are winless, desperate in front of their home fans to make an impact. And you can see the rain's just coming down there. Heather, I don't know if that will, how that might impact things, Scotland's game plan, for example.
Yeah, I know it was raining heavily out in Parma yesterday, so if it does come on a bit heavier, both teams with me might have to adapt, ball a bit slippier, line out might impact. But certainly Scotland's line out working really, really well this evening. Emma Wassell calling the line outs, and I think that pressure from the line out resulted in the try and the conversion. So exciting to see what's going to happen. Interesting, Scotland have been trying to go wide, sort of midfield quite early on. I think I'd like to see a bit more inroads. Solari and co are closing it down and wide, so I'd like to see a bit more kicking from Scotland into the corners and then going for the line out, and then also using the midfield. Molly Wright doing some fantastic runs up midfield, some really hard carries. Evie Gallagher as well doing some superb carries.
Interesting to see how Italy respond here. They've underwhelmed by their own standards in this Six Nations so far. I think a lot of people expected them to definitely at least be right in there for best of the rest behind England and France, but they've not really turned up so far.
A lot of rugby to be played. Remember, Italy are ranked 8th and Scotland are 10th.
And they did finish 2nd just a few years ago, a famous win over in France, so they are a hugely capable team. Scotland do look to go wide. Here's Rowley into the hands of Campbell, one-on-one with Magatti, who does her job and makes the tackle. Belisle, fantastic carrier for Scotland, has been all tournament.
Second back
to Law.
Hold low. On now.
Here's Furlan. Takes the contact from McLaughlin. Italy go wide, they've got a few numbers out. Scotland shuffle across. Bettoni.
Tackle!
It's Madia, looks for the pop pass. It was a little in front of the intended target, but they gathered nonetheless. Here's Madia running at the line. Rigoni. Furlan being ragdolled by Thompson. Baratin. This is the start Italy would have wanted. Hands on ball, making some yards. Still to get into Scotland's 22 though. Baratin. Veronese. It's ripped from Thompson. Fantastic from the Scotland centre.
Excellent work there.
Upper body strength just gets in there. No messing about. Plucks the ball straight out of the hands. And it halts Italy's momentum.
Taking back. Hold.
Nelson sends it long. Hold. Furlan.
Get on there.
Here's Mutso.
Okay, cool. Number.
Penalty. Advantage Italy's way.
Tackle!
Ragone goes tackle. Short. Tackle called. Ball goes to deck. Solari, good hands though. On to Veronese.
Leave it!
Baratin goes down the short side, but Sarah Bonner's there to put in a thumping hit. Spilled.
There's no advantage. Back over here. What was this?
The rain coming down. Very heavy now in Parma.
I can hear on the 15. Sorry, girls, on the 15. 13
Italy
blue.
Do some
high
good
tackle.
Attacking sets there. Medea definitely pulling the strings there at 10. Her passing is really outstanding.
Yeah, just rips the ball. Ragone makes the yards needed.
Yeah.
This is the infringement from Scotland.
Time's off, girls. Time's off. Time's off. Waiting for the lace. Yep. Time's on. Yeah, time's on now.
Difficult to see exactly what it was for there. Bettoni to throw in. Claimed by Locatelli. Oh, now Italy get the ball going, and this is ominous for Scotland. They're all over the place. Gallagher's on the deck. Italy still going over the top of them. Advantage coming. That was ferocious from the Italians. This is the start they wanted. As the rain pours down in Parma, they inch towards the Scotland line. Veronese places it back.
Hands and feet.
It's Madia. Ragone pulls it back. Oh, it just doesn't go to hand, and now they're scrambling. But it's Magatti up against Campbell. He makes a tackle along with Skeldon.
Hold! Hold here.
Italy just kicking the yards again. Baratin, good carry, and they're still going. Italy, there's a body in there, they're over the line. Is there a grounding? They certainly think so. Certainly looked like it.
Yeah, good, really good carry there just before, and then driving over the line. We'll see.
Ben Whitehouse, the TMO.
I believe it's held up, but can you just confirm that for me, please? That there hasn't been a grounding beforehand.
Yep, 2 seconds, we'll get the best angle now.
So again,
here's your best angle coming up.
The referee thinks it's held up.
Lauren, overturn your decision, give the try.
4-7, thank you.
Quick and clean from Ben Whitehouse, the TMO, and it is a try for Italy.
Double their tally in this year's Six Nations. Only scored one try so far, and that was last week against Ireland. I think it was Bettoni that was over. We'll just confirm.
Can you just have a chat to them?
Yeah, usually the hooker.
Yep. Collapsing the ball. Yeah, we were playing advantage.
Really powerful, advantage. Really powerful.
Scotland were just scrambling. They were on the back foot there. And
almost there. It was Scotland's passage of play just before the half time, and Italy then putting the pressure on Scotland there. And they kept possession really well. Some excellent passes and good forward carries as well.
And Solari, who packs a punch despite being fairly diminutive for a centre, but she is also an excellent kicker, as we saw with the early penalty, and she'll have the chance to level things here.
No.
Scotland say she started her run-up and attempt the charge down, but told by the referee to get back. Not that it phases Michaela Solari, who bisects the posts and squares the game. What a start to this second half by Italy.
There was Bottoni, Melissa Bottoni, who scored against Ireland last week for Italy, their only try so far, and getting her second. Normally plays at hooker, today starting at loose head, but she'll do whatever. Fantastic work rate around the park.
68th cap for Melissa Bottoni, celebrates it with a score and hauls her team back into this game. Nadia
white.
Clears.
On now.
Doesn't find touch though. Rowley puts the chip up, but it's claimed by Madia.
Okay.
You can see the surface glistening now. Tricky handling conditions for the players. Ragone puts one up high, tests Nelson, who makes the catch. Mathinson, the scrum half, goes for the little kick over the top, and it's very well executed. And that's what you talked about, Heather, just at the start of that second half, you'd like to see a lot more of.
Absolutely, I think it was actually Lisa Thompson there, a superb boot on her, and really making the corners. Like, obviously, is that 50-22? Let's see.
I think the referee called it as outside,
outside
the 50.
Outside, yeah,
so.
Yeah. Not this time. If it had been in their half, Scotland would have regained the line out. But still, good field position to put Italy under pressure.
Yeah, the new rule, obviously, if you kick it from your own half, it bounces in the opposition's 22 and goes out. Then you get the ball. Trial that's been introduced by World Rugby. Line out disrupted, and Scotland have it.
Fantastic
right
by Molly Wright.
Oh, okay, cool.
She's at the base of the ruck, does her job. Belial finds a little gap. Here's Law. You can see how slippy the ball is. It almost squirms from Leo's gap, but here's Thompson. Great angle.
Law slides.
Both teams just fighting for every inch.
Mathinson just digging away there to get the ball out. Skeldon, huge carry, helped by Wassel and Bonner, the second row pairing. That pass from Mathinson just too low, and was there a knock-on? There was, and that'll be a scrum to Italy.
Yeah, just maybe a wee bit rushed there, that the pass, so especially with the rain coming down now.
Yeah, she maybe just didn't get it, tried to whip it, just maybe didn't get the grip that she was after in the rain.
Just adapt slightly.
Scrum's been a fairly even contest so far. Scotland have had some good moments. Italy have had a penalty from it as well. Interesting to see what happens here with Italy deep in their own half.
Set.
Scotland get the shunt on, and they're driving Italy backwards. It's fumbled at the back by Arrighetti. Referee says backwards, but Baratin's been scragged under pressure.
Well done, Ragone there, picking it up at the back of the scrum.
Centre in there, saving
hold,
our team.
Hold.
Oh, and there's hands in the ruck there from Scotland.
Hands
that's careless. And Italy with a free
hands.
Exit.
You've won it.
Yeah, just very alert there by Ragone. Just a good ball player, a good eye.
Good kicker as well. Here she is. Gets Italy out of their 22. You can see the penalty count there in Italy's favour, 6-9.
Ragone just starting to look a wee bit more lively. Scotland are going to have to be on their watch.
Ten minutes into this second half, and Italy have given more or less the response they'd have been asked for in the changing rooms at half-time. Bottoni, the try-scorer, throws in. It's Madia. Ragone hit by Gallagher. Baratin tries to
tackle!
Snoop round the corner.
Hold! No, she's fine. She's fine. Tackle! Tackle! No, tackle!
Gatti in looking for work from her wing. Held up slightly, but does get to deck for Italy. Right. Sarah Law in there making the tackle. Here's Madia. Goes on the left foot, outside of the boot. Unconventional, but it's a lovely kick. It's a beautiful kick, and this could just short of what would have been a 50-22. Tremendous skill.
Really, as you said, like, coming round it on the left foot, but just getting great distance from that. Especially in the conditions now.
Remember, girls, come in.
Yeah, so unlucky here. If this had just gone another
couple of
half yard, Italy would have had the line out.
Yeah. Girls, super cross. Oh, sorry, mate.
Still, it's testing here for Scotland in these conditions. Need to get this right. Lassell gets the short ball, clever. Here's Gallagher. Again, makes the yards. Great carrier.
Hold
back
blow.
To Law.
Hold blow.
Got some time
hold.
To clear our lines,
yeah,
but
on there.
Only as far as Magatti. Tony. Italy in a good position again. Here's Solari. Duca. Madia shows and goes again, but she's met with fierce resistance on the inside.
Hold here.
Did that in the first half as well.
McLachlan with a chop tackle. Oh, and Scotland are in there again, but it's illegal, and Italy will have the chance to perhaps take some points.
Had to stay on your feet. Number three, sorry. Just here.
Italy, they are just going through the phases more, and Medea's more influence.
Six.
Kicking's working, the forwards are getting more carries, and just a bit quicker ball that Italy are getting than they did in the first half. And Christine there just off her feet, and the referee penalising her for that.
England against Ireland,
guys,
the final game of round four of the TikTok Women's Six Nations on BBC Two from 12 tomorrow. England obviously in pursuit of the title, looking to take it to that final game. And Ireland, Scotland, Scotland's final match away in Belfast against Ireland next week with us, 8 o'clock on BBC Scotland next Saturday. Here's the two tries. That was the Wassell score in the first half for Scotland, Batoni over for Italy, and Scotland just not had the ball they would hope for so far, Heather.
Yeah, really, I would like to see the possession
on.
But I think Italy have the majority of possession in this half. Started well, and they've just continued to do so.
Yeah, you can come forward.
Medea,
yeah.
Coming to the fore. Rigoni just
right here, yeah.
That in the own 22, that just staying alert and just keeping it alive and keeping their possession.
Michaela Solari will have the chance to put Italy into the lead in this game for the first time. Another perfect kick from the Italian centre, and Italy leads, much to the delight of their fans.
Yeah, well played, Italy. They've come out in this half and definitely got more solidity into this game. Scotland defence is staying strong. I'm impressed with Scotland's defence around the breakdown, but they're just finding a way through at the moment.
Yeah, just a couple of penalties given away from Scotland. Suddenly they were down in their own half. Here's Thompson to restart. That's immediately driven into touch. Great restart from Scotland's point of view. Lisa Thompson put it on a sixpence.
Absolutely great pressure there, getting the line out. Rona Lloyd not had much ball in hand, so she'll be looking to get her hands in this one.
We've seen that twice. Scotland going right to the touchline with the restart, and they've managed to regain it twice by Italy going into touch. And pretty good opportunity. Skeldon throws in. Claimed by Wassel. Referee says it wasn't straight.
Outside shoulder, not straight. Scrum or line out?
She's been consistent
line
on
out.
This.
Okay, line out's called.
She's been asking.
Okay.
If it goes to the outside shoulder,
subs,
she's going to call it.
Number 9 and 10. 9 and 10, sub.
So we're having a change of halfbacks here. Jenny Maxwell is going to replace Katie Mattinson at scrum half, and Sarah Law is off, and Hannah Smith is coming on. Wonder if that means Nelson going back to 10 and Smith going into the centre.
Right. Girls, the mark's here, sorry. Right.
Yes. Hannah usually plays at 13.
Yeah. Perhaps Lisa Thompson back at 12.
Yeah, just shuffling in.
Italy ball though, Bettoni. Don't gather, and Maxwell gets a first touch. She started the previous three games, Jenny Maxwell, on now to make an impact in the final 25 minutes.
Yeah, strong bench Scotland today, and that's exactly why she's there.
Here goes Wassel.
Yeah, I see that.
Right to McLaughlin.
Yeah, my...
Nelson, Thompson, into Smith with a first touch, first carry.
Leave it wide!
No
Leave
scrum
it.
Half at the moment. Scrum half's down, so Scotland have recognised this lovely pass.
Bonner makes the yards. Yeah, Jenny Maxwell immediately down on the far side, which is far from ideal.
Play
Scotland
on.
Play on. Belisle with a fend. Emma Wassel seems to be deputising at scrum half. Is there anything she can't do? There's Nelson. Thompson with the kick, just bounces before, and that is good, sensible play by Lisa Thompson.
Very good, Lisa Thompson. Excellent.
Oh, the mark,
really
baby.
Sensible.
It looks like Jenny Maxwell is in quite a bit of pain here. Not nice to see. Looking for some foul play, or whether Jenny Maxwell has just turned her ankle here, but either way, she is in a lot of pain.
Yeah, I think so as well.
I think she's just slipped.
Yeah, pitch is slipping.
Yeah, and her ankle is. Looks like her ankle anyway, and it's a real sore one. And Scotland need a rethink here, because Brian Eason's just made some changes, looking for to mix it up with a halfback change, and immediately your scrum half is injured.
Yeah. You'll have to have a think at that. Well done, the players there. Scotland recognising it. Rona Lloyd was the first to recognise it. She went at scrum half twice at the base and then passed the message through. Best wishes, Jenny. I hope you're okay.
Yeah. Cool. Thanks, Ben. Yeah.
Scotland just be regrouping. Emma just taking a moment there. Chance to discuss. Fine-tune a few issues.
Yeah, we looks like the stretcher is now coming on for Jenny Maxwell. Chance to regroup.
Yeah, Jenny was out with a bad knee injury and came back strong last year, so get well soon, Jenny.
ACL injury she had, as you say, Heather, and hopefully it's not the same thing, but she does look in some discomfort, and it is such a shame when someone comes off, shame in any situation, but a shame when she's just come on, literally her first touch, and She's going to be forced off, and Megan Gaffney is on, and it will force another reshuffle, because Megan Gaffney, traditionally a winger, of course.
Yeah.
So we'll need to see...
See who goes at scrum
See
half.
Who plays scrum half for the remainder of this game for Scotland. And this is the sort of adversity that, as a coach, as a group, you probably talk about all the time. And now it's about trying to respond.
Yeah, I'm sure that the players, well, whatever is organised, they will respond to it. And they've been through so much, Scotland, these last 2 years, and this is just another thing they have to deal with.
Yeah, we wish
best
Jenny.
Wishes,
yeah. Yeah, sorry, Heather.
Yeah, best wishes. Our hearts goes out to you, Jenny. Take care.
Yeah, we wish her well.
Matt's here, girls. Time's still off. We're just going to wait for him to fully move. Just hold the ball. Time's still off, guys. We're just waiting for them to fully move. Alright. Time's on.
Here we go. Italy with the line out. Stolen by Scotland. Malcolm nicks it. Rowley scoops it off the deck to Skeldon. Nice hands.
Chloe Rowley is your scrum half. Yeah, she plays it that for seven, so she'll have gone to scrum half now.
Here is Rowley in that deputy role. Malcolm. Good quick ball, Belial. This is as good a position as Scotland have been in this second half. Can they take something from it? Oh, the pass doesn't go to hand, it's sloppy, but it's play on.
Well done, Rachel McLaughlin, excellent at being alert.
Scotland just trying to recompose themselves after that loose ball. Here's Belial, latched onto by the captain, Malcolm. Spun wide, Smith into McLaughlin. Penalty, Italy.
Holding.
Rachel McLaughlin just holding on the deck.
Really good passage of play there by Scotland, but just need to be a wee bit quicker there at the breakdown. Okay. Really good in the first half there, just sort of falling off there, so just got to keep the intensity up. Chloe Rowley adapting superbly.
Yeah, absolutely. Tunisi on for Beatrice Piranesi. And Tunisi has been Italy's top carrier and tackler in the tournament so far, so a surprise she didn't start. But I suppose this is exactly what she's brought on for, to make an impact, and when she will hope to do as Italy get themselves out of their own 22.
Yeah, 31 carries, not bad. Not bad work over the three games.
Yeah, putting in a shift.
Yeah, Italy quick at the breakdown there.
Make sure you're inside the pin. Yeah, all good.
Final quarter, Italy leading by 3 points. Scotland have been down here for
Play
a while,
again,
but...
Knock on blue. Okay, cool. Play on here.
Knock on.
Girls, it was lost forward in the line out. Knock on. Taking in the air.
A lot of stoppages at the moment, you can understand, given the conditions.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
The disruption with that injury as well.
Yeah. The practice of this refocus. There, Sarah just getting her hand to the ball,
just a bit forward.
Good pressure at the line out there. Louise McMillan also on the bench tonight, one of Scotland's top carriers, in fact was the top carrier against France, so good option there as well, if required.
Crouch.
Big scrum this.
Bind. Sit. The girls. We've both gone down and they've slipped, so we're going to reset that. They've both gone down, they've slipped, we're resetting that. Be patient. I'm standing this way, yeah.
Referee Lauren Jenner's definitely been clear, concise. No messing about this evening.
Yeah, we're at the 60-minute mark and it's slippy and you've got to work a wee bit harder. And 60 minutes in for the front row, no changes yet. You've just got to really concentrate on keeping your balance, keeping the weight forward.
Crouch.
Crouch. Bound. Set.
Scotland get the shove on again. They've been dominant the last few, and they get the penalty. What a shove. The body position's there, Heather.
Just what we were talking about there, the way and the balance and the speed and then the secondary drive was outstanding.
Those are the kind of moments that can turn games.
Yeah, I just feel there's a bit of a lull here with that sort of break with the injury, etc. And I think Scotland and Italy both need to refocus and up the standard a wee bit. Fantastic scrum.
Number two.
The forwards. Doing their job there expertly. Italy going backwards, not for the first time in the scrum. And now Lisa Thompson has put Scotland deep into the Italian 22.
Time's on.
As Silvia Turani comes on.
Yeah, this is Turani's. Yeah, she's been out injured for a while as well, so this is her first Six Nations match tonight.
Claimed by Scotland, nice and clean this time. Skeldon has it under a rockster. Making progress. Still Skeldon. Scotland inching closer.
Okay, that's one.
Great patience by Lana at the back there.
She gives it out to Rowley. There's Nelson looking for the line, but Madia is in there.
Roll, she's fine.
Skeldon. Great tackle.
Can you check that, please, Ben?
Here's Thompson. Squirms from her grasp. Gets another chance. Makes it for the line.
Lost the line. Lost.
Here's Nelson. It's Campbell. Scotland just can't work the space. It's offloaded, though, to Megan Gaffney for the corner. Brilliant tackle from Aura Mutso.
Mutso knew how important that was. I think they're
no,
just taking the tackle as well.
Campbell did well to get that away. It's just aggressive tackling.
Play through it, okay, cool.
Yeah, real mindset there from Mutso that okay, cool, Gaffney wasn't. That's one of Gaffney's favourite angles to run the tries in from.
Time's off.
Manuela Furlan down injured. It's another stoppage which.
Yeah.
It's not really helping the momentum of this game, the flow of this game. It's messy out there. That was Scotland's best passage of this second half, and Megan Gaffney just ran out of room, really.
Very much so. Some really good carries, though, and good hands keeping the ball alive. Shona Campbell doing well. Missed tackles 8-6. Quite low. Both sides have been working really, really hard in defence.
Yeah, these Scotland had made the fewest tackles of anyone in the tournament before this game, which shows you how much ball they've had in their three games. But Italy, with their captain on the deck, Manuela Furlan, she was off earlier for an HIA.
Yeah, he's the
She'll not be wanting to go off if at all possible.
The ball was able to be played quickly.
Stretching her hamstring.
Cramp.
Yeah, a bit of cramp.
Yeah, I think it's cramp.
Yeah.
We're just waiting for your player.
Okay, thank you very much.
Although it's raining, it's hot work out there.
Fullbacks aren't allowed to get cramp, surely, Heather.
No, she's forgiven the 85th cap. She knows what it's about.
Yeah.
Ready, cockpit?
Both sides working furiously out there to get the first win they desperately crave.
Six.
And
yeah.
At the moment,
six,
with 17
six,
minutes
six.
To go, it's
She's
Italy
in,
who are heading
off.
For that.
So. All right. Time's on.
The Tony throws in. Italy claim under pressure.
Oh!
Scotland put the shunt on. That's a great response from Italy.
Indeed.
Okay, that's one.
Fantastic running
ball.
still going. Phenomenal. They've made
so hard to stop.
20 metres plus from Italy. Penalty as well. Fantastic from the Italians. That is just what they needed.
Just stayed tight, so hard to stop once the momentum was there.
Girls, time's not off. Time's not off.
Batone at the front there, and Guy, look at Guy. Both props working really, really hard there.
You expect a few changes in the forwards, Heather, for Scotland. They've still got the same pack out there.
Yeah, I think I'd bring Louise McMillan on. Another line-out option, and really superb ball carrying and tackling as well, so I think that's an option. We've also got Leah Bartlett and Katie Dugan up front for the in the forwards, and Jodie Retty, she'll be covering back row as well. Anne Young is also on the bench, so we've got another prop there, another option.
Yeah, bring them on, mate.
Yeah, Furlan's gone off for Minuzzi for the second time, but this time I don't think she'll be coming
back. On the line.
It's about this time you often see teams change their whole front row, but Scotland still with Wright, Skeldon and Belial out there.
It's a good combination, that, both offering a lot around the park as well, but right, it's 65-minute mark, you want to keep it fresh.
Girls, you're on the line.
It's a long shift for them, given the work they get through. Tony, that's loose, and it's advantage for a squint throw, which Scotland will gleefully accept.
Yes, not straight, we're playing advantage. No, we're playing advantage, wasn't straight. Scrum. Scrum, girls?
Okay. Tony's having to scrum and throw. Big ass. Well done, Tony.
Cool, bring them on. Sub. Scotland number one, girls.
And
number
just
one.
As we were saying, it looks like Molly Wright is run her race, and Leah Bartlett, who started the previous three games, is on in her place.
Well done, Molly Wright. Absolutely excellent. Really good shift in the scrum line out, and also around the park in attack and defence. Well done.
You see that there.
Nine carries,
15 tackles for the front row.
Yeah.
Good numbers.
Outstanding. And 48 metres.
Yeah, those are back row numbers from a prop.
Really good.
Raleigh with the put in, the acting scrum half. Scotland, of course, losing replacement Jenny Maxwell to injury. Here they come. Chance to stretch the legs, but they've not had in a while. Smith gets the offload away. Nelson makes a few metres. The kick goes through. That's a nice little grubber.
Yeah, excellent grubber. That was a good pass to play off that scrum. Christine Belial was under pressure there, but Evie Gallagher, I like what she's doing at the base of the scrum. It's really unobtrusive, unfussy, and I like how she's working there.
We were happy, me and my are happy, but we'll watch
that. Scotland choosing to put the pressure on in these conditions. The lineouts have been loose, understandably so. Here's Batone. That time it goes to plan. This ball, running ball again from Italy, is proving huge, and here they come, striding away into Scotland's half.
That's your tight head prop, fantastic.
Lucia Hagai, incredible. Here's Rigoni with the right foot. Fantastic kick from Rigoni, really intelligent play from Italy.
She's in the zone now, she's in the zone.
Beatrice Rigoni, 53rd cap, and she scored two against Scotland last year, two tries, starting to make her influence. This is the run from Sia Guy, though, your prop in the final 13 minutes.
She still can run like that after scrumming, well done. 208 minutes she's played in the last three matches as well, she's valuable to Italy.
And now it's Scotland's line out under pressure. Oh, Italy steal it. It's Baratin with a ball in her hands. great carry. Tunisi.
Play on.
Oh, Scotland have pinched it. Bonner's there. Gets it away to McLaughlin.
You've lost it wide. You're off it. Not on the ball.
Lisa Thompson went for the free kick and then charge down came in and eventually it's prodded away.
Well done under pressure there, Scotland. Italy really, really turning the screw there, but well done Hannah Smith to get the kick away.
Okay.
Christine Belair with what looks like a little gash on her shin there.
I think she's been nursing that for a while. It's just, she seems to have it bound up during training and matches.
I can't hear you, sorry.
Very stop start at the moment.
Yeah.
It's not been a thriller, but it is compelling as we enter the final 12 minutes.
Yeah. Okay,
cool. Yeah, both teams now going into the reserve. This is what all the training's for. Both teams should be able to cope with this. They do so much training. This is what you train for, these last 12 minutes of an international match.
Yeah, and Italy were obviously boosted. Not that make an impact this week at all, but the contracts that they're being handed out in preparation for the World Cup, 25 of them. There's an advantage being played here. Some infringements at the line-out from Scotland and Italy. Turning the screw. Scotland don't know where the ball is and now they're on the back foot. Italy striding forward once more again. And it's lost forward, I think, there in the...
But
we'll go back for the advantage.
Number four. In three.
Yeah, Scotland have given away a couple of penalties like that. It's really hard once the maul is formed to stop it legally, and that's what Scotland are giving away in the penalties for, a side entry to the maul.
Number four, yeah,
Emma Wassell, the guilty party there, I think. 13 penalties, not ideal reading for Brian Eason, Scotland coach. And now we've got Rachel McLaughlin on the deck. So many tired bodies out there.
Yeah. All right. Time's up when you're ready.
I feel like I've been saying it's the final 12 minutes for 12, 11 minutes forever, but here we go.
Rachel, that's the second or third maul penalty that we've had. So we just need a little bit of discipline in this area.
Okay, there's the warning there from the referee, though, about the side entries in the mauls.
You started with
and you think if there's another one, that'll be yellow card time, which Scotland can't afford at this stage. 10 minutes to go, 3 points down. Here we go. Claimed. Italy's maul has sprung to life in the last 10 minutes and they're using it here. Deception to keep the ball. Trundles forward. Batoni maybe has it in there.
Yeah. Out now, girls! Out now!
Better recycling by Scotland, though.
That's one!
Tunisi. And Italy still coming. Skeldon with a thunderous hit to keep Italy at bay. Here goes Batoni again, though, looking for a second try.
Hands and feet.
Scotland hanging on by their fingernails here. A lunge for the line. Are Italy over?
She's short,
says the referee.
Hands and feet. Hands and feet.
They go for it again.
Short again.
Looks short. It is short. They celebrate. Try given. Scotland's resistance is broken. Bodies all over the floor. But Italy strike.
We're just gonna go time. Time's off. Okay, cool. Perfect. Girls, time's off. We're just gonna check the ground. We're just gonna check the grounding. Ben, we're coming to you.
Ben Whitehouse, the TMO, will have a look.
The decision is try. But we just want to check the grounding, please.
So we're going to play that for you now.
Oh, and was there downward pressure there?
Is there another angle?
Oh, it's... Ooh. Is there daylight between...
Okay, I have a decision for you.
I'm not sure.
The ball is grounded first. then lost forward, so you may award the try.
Awesome. You can hear Ben Whitehouse, the TMO, on-field decision stands.
Well done, Italy. They went, where they went one way, and then twice, and then we went down to left-hand side, so well done. On-field decision, it was under control and then lost. Yeah, you can see it there.
Yeah, just squirms as the pressure that she puts on the ball on the deck forces it from her grasp. But it's a blow for Scotland at this.
You need to keep going, please.
And that's all really
stage.
Come from, yeah, the
Sylvia
the
roller, Turani.
Yeah, Sylvia Turani, she was delighted. That all really came from the breakout rolling mall down the other side.
And she's made an impact on her return from injury. And now it's Michaela Solari who has been perfect with the boot. And she is again, fantastic conversion. And Italy are 10 points in front.
Oh, bring them on.
Heading for their first win of this TikTok Women's Six Nations. Scotland with a fight on their hands to rescue it here.
Yeah, that was very much a forwards try. Well done, Italy. Worked really well, the rolling ball there.
Rachel McLachlan has made way for Scotland. Restart not quite gathered to plan, but Mutso.
Still time, 72 minutes.
Louise McMillan is the player who's made her way on for Rachel McLachlan. Can Scotland force a mistake here?
Hold.
Rigoni, the right boot, doesn't find touch. Thompson gathers. Little step on the outside, gets the offload away. Oh, it's kicked forward by Italy, but it's dived on by Shona Campbell.
Excellent work on the ground there by Shona Campbell.
Important Scotland held on to that ball. Here's Chloe Rowley, unfamiliar 15's position of scrum half, gets it away well, nice hands.
She's doing well there.
Belial over the ball. Here's Nelson. Campbell did really well to hold that, but she had no chance of making the over the game
lost
line.
It there, White. Lost it wide.
Rowley again, incredible to get the ball away under severe pressure.
Really good balance.
I'm taking the half back out.
Yeah, not penalty. Like to do that through the rock, take out the half back, take out Chloe.
Yep. Infringing through the middle. And this is perfect for Scotland. But they need to make this field position count. Need to retain their patience.
Lisa Thompson's kicking has been excellent tonight. It's just getting that patience, and they've got the ball, and it's just building the patience, and then turning it into points.
Yeah, it's 17-0 to Italy in this second half, and that's the disappointing thing for Scotland. The conditions haven't helped the game they want to play, but Italy have done really well with two well-worked tries, but Gallagher takes it forward. Belial dusted off the slight injury she had before, and it's knocked on by Bonner. But it's a penalty for offside. Scotland with another chance to get close to the Italian line. What's the decision going to be here? They're taking the points, Heather. What do you make of that?
Yeah, because obviously there's 10-point difference. They take the points now, and that's three, and then it's a converted try. So that's what they're aiming for.
Yeah, that would force the draw. Helen Nelson is 2 from 2 so far this afternoon, and this evening, sorry, a penalty in it. Conversion, and it's important she gets this here. See, the wind just takes it off the tee. Lisa Thompson going in to hold it in place. Big kick. Squeeze through the post. Job done for Helen Nelson.
Well done, Helen. Well done.
We're back to a scored game.
Obviously, Scotland are sitting on one competition point and Italy have none. So if it's a draw, Scotland would still be above Italy in the points table.
Yeah, Scotland win from here looks a challenge. But they could definitely salvage a draw with 3.5 minutes gone. And then you never know.
You never know.
Italy, as it stands, heading for a first win of this year's Six Nations. Goes up, it's knocked on.
Advantage.
Rona Lloyd couldn't gather. And Italy have the advantage. Baratin marshalling the troops. Experienced Centurion scrum half. Celari. And this suits Italy fine, just eating up the seconds. Baratin, Madia. Carried forward by Tunisi.
Yeah, advantage is over.
Madia. Pagoni met with some stern defence.
She's fine, she's fine. Hold here.
We see a guy still making the yards.
Ball's available. Use it.
Referee tells Thank Italy you. To get on with it. Sarah Baratin does. Madia hit backwards. Prodded through by Rigoni. And they'll ask Scotland to go from their own 22 here.
Yes, good attacking play there, just in their, in Scotland's half. That's exactly where the Italians want to play their rugby. Rachel Malkin there putting in some tremendous hits. And there we have it, Michaela Sarari, TikTok Women's Six Nations Player of the Match. Well done, Michaela.
Yeah, don't think you'd argue with that, would you, Heather?
Some outstanding defence and her kicking and some really just smart attacking play.
This is an example of our prowess with the boot. It really is fantastic. It's such a weapon to have. And she's kicked everything that's been put in front of her this evening, and it's a large part of why her side are 7 clear.
Yep. Were you checking that tackle? Informally? Okay, cool, perfect. Happy play on. Time's on, girls. Line out.
Lana Skelda needs to make this. Or you suspect it's curtains for Scotland's chances.
Both teams.
And it's not gathered. It is regathered. Bonner clutches it and gets it away. You can see the rain is just absolutely pouring down. It's so going to be so difficult for Scotland to get up the pitch. With ball in hand, Rowley. Goes back to Nelson and she'll kick it up in the air.
Girls, there's no advantage. It was lost forward. Yeah.
So the referee's saying there's a knock on there.
Lost forward, scrum here on the 15.
Obviously an Italian hand in the line out, which means that Scotland will have the scrum.
1 minute
to go. Italy quite happy to keep that clock ticking over Scotland.
Okay.
Want the scrum to happen.
Final 30 seconds, final play. It's going to be, barring any infringements, Scotland's chances of a first Six Nations win here slipping away. Draw still on the cards. Thompson on the Lloyd on the wraparound. She's got numbers outside her. She spots a gap. Taken down by Solari again. They're going for broke Scotland. They go the other way. Thompson gets that fend in. Gaffney in. Nelson. The clock is red. Scotland with still so many metres to travel. Nelson tries to evade the contact.
No, she's lost it!
They're appealing.
No, not on it.
Nothing there, says the referee. Smith onto Shona Campbell, smashed.
That was an outstanding tackle there.
Stay down.
Smith whips it back. Scotland need to go wide here if they've got the numbers. Thompson sorts the gap, tries to get the arms free, but Italy defend again, and Solari's in there over the ball. She's got her hands on it. The penalty's there, and that will be victory for Italy. A fantastic second-half performance from the Italians. They were 10-3 down at the break. But tries from Turani and first Bettoni.
The forward rolling mall, the running mall was just outstanding.
There is the victory, the full-time whistle. And Scotland are still without a win in this Six Nations in four attempts. They played well in the first half, the rain came down and they just couldn't get enough ball. It's finished Italy 20, Scotland 13.
Yes, victory for Italy. Colin Gregor, you didn't predict that one correctly. What on earth happened there? Italy's just so strong coming out in that second half.
Yeah, just started the second half really, really well. Got on the front foot. Just the wet conditions almost played into the Italian hands, that they were less expansive with their attacking game. Stuck it up the jumper a bit more, got their rolling maul going, and just the pick and goes, and it was too much for Scotland. Both tries going up to the TMO, but yeah, you can see the grounding there. And again, here it's just the pick and go. Once you're in that position, it's so, so difficult to defend. What Italy do well is they've been coming to the right, then they just dive back down that blind side. And although the ball squirts away, it's clearly grounded first of all. And in those conditions, a 10-point lead's just, it's a huge lead. And yep, Italy deserved victors on the second
indeed.
Half performance.
I mean, there are so many positives we can take away for Scotland, one of them being their try in the first half.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was, it just showed hard work and determination, and that's maybe something that lacked a little bit in the second half. Italy came at a different side in the second half, but this is definitely a well-worked try. You can see loads of great carries from the forwards and a great finish from Emma Wassell there with a little step inside. And to get over the line is just great. Yeah.
Just briefly, Colin, they talk about their consistency getting better. Did we see that today?
Again, it was a half. They played well in the first half. They played well in the second half against France. So it's still trying to piece together a 60, 70, 80-minute performance. And one more chance to do it in this Six Nations.
Yes, indeed. Well, thank you to both of you for joining us this evening, Megan. And, well, yourself as well, even though you got it wrong. We'll
My
not
fault.
Hold that against you, shall we? Yes, and thank you very much to our commentary team today, who are Thomas Duncan and Heather Lockhart. We'll be back next week as Scotland will take on Ireland in their last Six Nations game. Just briefly, Megan, how do you think they're going to cope against Ireland, I guess?
I think they'll have a point to prove next weekend, so I think it'll be a good contest.
Yes, we'll have to wait and see. Thank you very much to both of you. We'll be back next week on the BBC Scotland channel. Bye-bye.